Mega Praise Ministries, we're out to reach the lost, to bring the lost sheep back home, to build a relationship between God and man, for the worship, the presence, the healing, the restoring. That's what it's about. The restoring of the homes, the restoring of the families, the healing of the bodies, to enjoy a relationship with the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. We love the worship. We love the outpouring of the presence of God. This is what this ministry is all about, Mega Praise Ministries, to see what that was lost. How you doing? God bless you. My name is Pastor Manuel Johnson. This is Mega Praise Ministries, and we have a special program for you, a dynamic message. And I just pray that the message that we're teaching you today would be an impartation into your life and that you can be blessed. And then later on, I'm going to come back after the message and talk with you and pray with you. And we have some special product for you that's going to bless your socks. So right now, let us take you into the studios and enjoy the message, and I'll be right back. God bless you. People that are watching at home, lift your hands up before the Lord. Come on, come on, let's open it up with worship in this place. Holy Lord. Holy Lord. Glory, glory. For your name is holy. For your name is holy, holy Lord, holy, holy Lord, Lord. And for your name is holy, holy Lord. People at home, lift your hands up before the Lord and give Him glory and give Him honor and give Him praise. And for your name is holy, holy Lord, holy Lord, for your name is holy, yes Lord, holy Lord, holy Lord, holy Lord, for your name. Holy Lord. Let's give the Lord a mighty hand praise. Hallelujah. God bless you. 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 Hallelujah. Welcome to Mega Praise Ministries. Thank you for coming and allow me in your home today. My name is Pastor Manuel Johnson, and we're going to talk about the promises of God. And saints, I just want you to be encouraged because God's promises are yea and amen. Can I hear everybody say it? Yea and amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give Him praise. Let's put our Bibles towards heaven. I believe that this is the inspired, living Word of God from Genesis to Revelation. This will bless me. This will heal me. And this will set me free. In Jesus' mighty name. Come on, give the Lord a mighty hand praise. Thank you, Jesus. We were talking about wonderful messages on the promises of God. And like this is you just can't have enough of it. You can't get enough of it. But I'm going to give you some more nuggets today, so I hope you're ready. Open your Bibles right now to Isaiah 34. I want to read from the book of Isaiah 34, and I want you to understand what the Lord tells us, because I want you to really hold on to God's promises on your life. You know, some of you are looking at me and says, well, God has never promised me anything. Well, have you ever sought Him to find out? There, Jeremiah tells us that God has a future for you, a future of good and not of evil. That's a big promise. But some of us don't even know God's future because we're chasing our own future. We're chasing our own ideas, our own cars, our own concept. Are we looking at somebody else's life and we're chasing his lifestyle or their lifestyle? And God has a perfect plan for you. And the promises of God is perfect if we would just trust him. I've learned that. Many of us have learned that. Many of us have made mistakes thinking that God was in it and he wasn't, or wanting the God to be in it. Many of us, we've spent money, traveled, and done all kinds of things and been in all kinds of places, and God wasn't in it. What a waste. Why? When we can sit there and embrace God's promises. God's promises is not based off what's going to happen 10 years from now when it comes to pass. Some of us, we forget that. We get a prophecy, and the prophecy, yeah, that might be 1% of God's promise. But God's promises is every single day in your life. Amen. Every single day, God has a divine will for you and me. And his promises, and he wants you to fulfill that promise for this day. But some of us, we have already have it in our mind what we're going to do. Many of us, 50% of the day, we did not fulfill God's word and promises on our life. Many of us. Because we have allowed distraction, worry, concerns, things of the world to allow us to go left field. And sometimes many of us listens to the enemy. What's the enemy, you're saying, those that are watching me? The devil. Ooh, don't get scared. This is not one of those creepy channels. Yes, but he is real. I know you don't like to hear that, but the devil is real. You can't see him, but he's real. And he has a plan for your life. You can ignore me, or you can keep it on that channel. God has a better plan for your life. Devil has a plan of destruction. Those that are watching me right now, even here, the devil has a plan for destruction. It will end in destruction. Anything that you do that follow Satan will end in destruction. It will end in a separation from God. It will cost you much more to follow Satan than it will to follow God. And then eventually it will take your eternity. And there's no turning back. And many people are following the ways of the devil. Why do you think Jesus tells us in Matthew, the road to destruction is broad? Do you hear me, those that are watching at home? The road to destruction is broad. And Jesus said, many go through that gate. Many follow that road. That is not the promise of God. God's promise that he wishes that no one, is his will, that no one perishes. That's a promise that he wants to give you, that you may not perish. But many of us, we perish every single day. We're perishing. Every single day, hell is being exploded. Because people are following their own concept, their own ideas. And they're trying to chase that almighty currency. For those that are watching me around the world, I can't use dollar currency. But when are we going to say, Lord, I want to do your will today? And tomorrow, Lord, I want to do your will. When you submit yourself to God's plan, his promises are going to come and overflow you. It's going to overtake you, his promises. They will overtake you when you're submitting to the will of the Most High God. His promises will overtake you to where you will not be able to contain it. It blesses others. The Bible tells us the first promise that Abraham received in Genesis 12. Leave your kindred, your people, to a place I will show you. That's the promise. That means God says, I will be with you where you're going. I'm going to direct you. Amen. He says, and I will bless you and make you a mighty nation. That was a promise. That was a promise that his own daddy couldn't give him. Your parents cannot tell you you're going to be a mighty nation. They can't see that far, but God can. That's a promise. The first thing that Abraham found out, that he had a promise bigger than his own family. It was so big that God says, leave your kindred. That's right. God says, we'll start our own family. My God, give him a give him praise in the house of the Lord. He says, we'll start our own family. Leave your kingdom. God's promise on us is so big. But many of us, trying to deal with these certain plans of our life. We miss it. God has so much more. Saints, you will bring people to the Lord because of the promise of God on your life.
Hi, I'm Shiva Johnson. We pray you are enjoying this program and these teachings. We have some wonderful offers for you today. This will give you a chance to support the ministry of God and will give us a chance to bless you. The first one, the Lord had me call this book Total Makeover in 21 Days because its purpose is to bless you, to give you a total makeover on the inside that will show on the outside. As you meditate on the truths shared in this book and as you apply the wisdom tips that are in the book, it will truly impact your life in a positive manner. The next one is an audio teaching called The Government of Christ. You see, this teaching will give you a new perspective on your purpose in life as a believer. Purpose gives your life meaning. Hallelujah. And this teaching will explain to you that how believers as rulers and as officials of the kingdom of God, of the government of Christ, have the same mission as Christ. This is healing scriptures. My husband has put healing scriptures together to bring healing to your minds and to your bodies. And there's been testimonies of people being blessed and healed by listening to this CD over and over again. Remember, you have to keep listening to the Word of God over and over again until it gets into your spirit. It becomes part of you. That's when it shows its power and it impacts your life. You can attain all these products on our website, that is megapraiseministries.com. God bless you. We'd love you to join us next time again. Goodbye.
He says, I will bless you and I will make you a mighty nation. A nation? A nation. And then God gives you more. He says, I'm going to tell you something, Abraham. Follow me. And anybody, because you followed me, whoever blesses you, I'm going to bless them. Look at that promise. He says, because you follow, whoever bless you, I'm going to bless them. And he says, oh, don't worry, I'm going to take care of your enemies. Whoever come against you, whoever curses you, I'm going to curse them. So the promise of blessing and promises of protection. Come on. Promises of blessings and promises of protection. But many of us, my God, we try to protect ourselves. But God told Abraham. And people said, he said, nations will be blessed because of you. That wasn't just for him. That wasn't just for him. That's for those that follow the living God. Joseph followed the living God. Abraham was already dead. That was part of his seed. But he followed the living God. And what happened? Nations were blessed because of Joseph. Oh, you missed that thing. You missed that thing. Nations were blessed, saints that are watching me, because of Joseph. One man. Why? Because I'm going to follow God. Daniel was one man. A whole kingdom was blessed under Daniel's administration. Why? Because he followed the living God. He followed the plan of God. What is wrong with us? Saints that are watching me, God has a huge plan for your life. Some of us, we may be 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 years old watching me right now. He said, well, what about me? What about Moses? Moses was 80. My God, he just started. Moses thought that, oh, I'm just going to be a shepherd for my father-in-law. 80 years old. 1 year after God spoke to him on that mountain of God, the Bible tells us in the book of Exodus, 1 year, He came back with 2 million people. My God, give him glory. For 40 years, Moses was watching Jethro's sheep back and forth around and about the mountain. And 1 year, he accepted God's calling on his life. 1 year. He came back, and Jethro's like, whoa, whoa, look at the people. He brought a whole nation out of bondage. He kept saying in the beginning, 1 year before, send somebody else, send somebody else. Saints, what's wrong with us? God's plans. Jethro only saw his son-in-law as far as a sheep shepherd, sheep herder. That's it. That's as far as the eyes of Jethro. That was his father-in-law. That's all he saw. Oh, he saved my daughter. You get to marry my daughter. You need a job? Okay, you can watch the sheep. After 10 years of doing that, he's still watching sheep. Another 10 years go by. It's 20 years now. He's still watching sheep. Another 10 years, 30 years now. Moses is still watching the sheep. Man's plan. After another 10 years, God says, enough is enough. Moses, get up here. What? Get up here. Yes, yes. I got something bigger and better for you. I need you to take a leave of absence. Go tell your father-in-law, I've called you. He told his father-in-law, I need to go. God has called me. 1 year later, his father-in-law, in 40 years you've been working for me, in 1 year the mighty God did this. My God. Jethro, his father-in-law, the Bible said Jethro became a believer. Give the Lord hand praise. Saints, you will bring people to the Lord. Because of the promises of God on your life. People, are you receiving this? Because of the promise of God on your life, you will bring people to the Lord. Every one of you have a potential. He doesn't want to know about your ability. He wants to know about your availability. Wherever you're at and wherever you're at, Lord, I want to know your plan. And God will start unveiling it to you. And brothers and sisters, it's going to sound big. Those that are watching me, it's going to sound big. Don't worry. Don't let it overtake you. Because Moses was afraid. It sounded so big to Moses. Whoa, whoa, whoa. But anytime God gives you his plan, he gives you his anointing on you. When Moses was tending to the sheep, it was all in the natural. It was all by self. But when Moses went to Egypt, man, God, that rod was anointed. Had anointing of God with him. God's plans requires you to be anointed. You will be anointed. Because he'll open those doors. But if many of you would just say, Lord, I want to know your plan. Your divine will. I want my life. Watch what will happen to you. Watch what will happen to you. It will come to pass. How many of you right now that are watching me, even in the audience and not at home, would love for the Lord to use you? Let me see your hands. Even at home, let me see your hands. Well, God can see them at home. And I tell you something. Submit to the Lord. Watch what will happen. I'm going to give you some more scriptures. Quickly, go to Isaiah 34. Go to Isaiah 34. Isaiah 34, verse 16. Isaiah 34, verse 16. Nice and loud.
Search from the book of the Lord and read. Not one of these shall fail.
Search from the book of the Lord and read. Not one of them of these shall fail. None of God's words will fail, saints. It won't. We will fall. We will fail. We will come short, but his word will not fail. Read that again for us, reader.
Not one shall lack her mate.
Not one shall lack her mate.
For my mouth has commanded it, and his spirit has gathered them.
Amen. Go to verse 16 again.
Search from the book of the Lord.
God
and
wants
read.
You to search His Word. Search His Word. Read on, my reader.
Not one of these shall fail.
Not one of these. You're in the book. Not one shall fail. Quickly, I want to give you something more. Go to Psalm 105. One of the things that I like about Moses is that he'd always reminded God of his promise. Go to Psalm 105. Psalm 105, verse 42. The Bible tells us, Lord, you know, remember your promises. Psalm 105, verse 42, nice and loud.
For he remembered his holy promise.
For he remembered his holy promise. Let's say it together, holy promise. Let's say it with a little bit of authority, holy promise. Anytime God speaks to you, it's holy, saints. It's not like a man. When God speaks over you, it's holy. Why do you think the devil tries to stop it or prevent it or hinder it? Saints, I have to tell you something. The devil tends to know more about the promises of God on our life than you and I. Moses was not even, what, 1 year old yet and was right when he was born. Pharaoh decides there are too many Israelites. What happened? He ordered his people to take the male children and drown them in the Nile River. That's not a coincidence. Right during the time Moses was born, that was totally devil. Saints, the devil knows things about the promises of God on your life. He may not know the details, but he knows because he sees that anointing, that calling, that mantle on you. Even when Moses had not been one yet, he was up against opposition. Did you see that, saints?
Yes.
But God took care of that thing. As a baby, God preserved Moses. And he will preserve you if you believe it. Because his mother knew there was something about that baby. And God preserved Moses and had the enemy raise him. Amen. That's nothing but the Lord. Give the Lord praise. Amen. Those of you that are watching me at home, I know that there have been things going on. And you've been coming up with oppositions and trouble here and trouble there. But I want to encourage you to hang on. I want to tell you how much God has a plan for your life. He has a plan for your life. But you need to know who He is. He is Jesus Christ. I've been talking about the Savior. I've been talking about the Redeemer. Jesus Christ, the Lord and Savior. Until you submit yourself to the Lord, there is no possible way you can walk in the ways of the Lord. So why don't you give yourself to God right now? I'm going to go more into this later. Why don't you call on the name of the Lord? Jesus, come into my life. Be my Lord and Savior forever. Forgive me of my sins. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to serve you. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. I'm yours forever. In Jesus' name, amen. Come on, give the Lord praise. Hallelujah. I'll see you next time on Mega Praise Ministries. God bless you. Love you. Hi, welcome back. I pray you enjoyed that message. I have a very special offer for you today. If you really enjoyed it, you know, want you to be my partner, help me take the message around the world to the homes. And by doing that, we have a special offer. If you enjoyed today's message, any gift for any amount, we'll send this message out to you. Just write to us. Go on our website, makeapraiseministry.com. You can write to us, and the address is on the screen. And tell them that you would like to have this message of any amount. Just give us a name of the message, and we'll send it right out to you. I want you to be blessed. And also, I want to pray for your needs. I understand that we're all going through some tough times. And you know what? The answer is Jesus. He's been there for me. He's taken me out of good and bad. He's always been there for me. And he'll be there for you. Let's touch and agree right now. Heavenly Father, I just pray for everyone that's watching me right now. under the sound of my voice, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, Lord, that you've come and just engulfed their life and just blessed them. Lord, turn the things around that's happening in their life. I pray over the sick, those that are sick in body, Lord. I speak healing to that body in the name of Jesus. Lord, there's those that are going that have addictions and have strongholds, Father. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we break those strongholds in Jesus' mighty name. Just believe right now, and I know that the Lord is touching many of you right now, right at this moment. It is Jesus. He's the healer. And remember, the Bible says that if you call upon the name of the Lord, He will be there. He will answer you. He will not turn you away. So call upon His name today. And I'll see you next time. And remember, come partner up with this ministry. Be a blessed. Be a blessing, and we'll be a blessing too. In Jesus' name, talk to you later. Bye-bye.